Should all of the OTT platforms be regulated? We know television is regulated right now. Films ideally should just be given the rating. And if it's A rating, then anything goes. But that's not how it works in India. They still recommend, the censor board recommends cuts. And still cuts films based on a idea of morality and what goes and what doesn't go. Should that also happen then to the stuff you watch online? We have Satyam Singh Rajput, who's the petitioner in this case. Mr. Rajput, why do you believe that Sacred Games should be, should be censored?
मैडम मैं यहाँ पे सेक्रेट गेम या किसी कंटेंट पे बात नहीं कर रहा
जी.
मैं स्पेशली यहाँ पर बात कर रहा हूँ लीगल पॉइंट पे
जी. बोली
जहाँ पे नेटफ्लिक्स या अमेजन प्राइम जो कि और अदर ओटीटी जितने भी प्लेटफॉर्म्स हैं इंडिया में चलाए जाते हैं उस पे किसी भी तरीके की रेगुलेशन नहीं है. तो मैंने सिर्फ इस पिटीशन में उन पे रेगुलेशन की डिमांड की और जब तक रेगुलेशन नहीं है तब तक के लिए इन पे बैन कर दिया जाए. क्योंकि जो चीजें सीबीएफसी सेंसर्ड होती है क्योंकि टोटली अनसेंसर्ड है और कोई भी चीज अगर ये पास करना चाहते हैं तो उसको बाईपास करते हुए ये लाकर जो है इस पे नेटफ्लिक्स या अमेजन प्राइम पे डाल देते हैं.
नहीं तो आप मुझे एक बात बताइए, आप मुझे एक बात बताइए, तो आपको क्यों ऐसा लगता है कि रेगुलेशन होनी चाहिए?
इसलिए लगता है क्योंकि इसमें एक तो वीमेंस को जो है ऑब्जेक्टिफाई किया गया है, सेक्स को दिखाया गया, वल्गरिटी जिस तरीके से चीजें दिखाई जा रही हैं, नशे को दिखाया जा रहा है, इस पे हमें लगता है गवर्नमेंट का कोई ना कोई हस्तक्षेप जरूर होना
क्यों चाहिए. क्या आपको लगता है कि अगर आपको पसंद नहीं आया तो आप मत देखिए ना, फिर आप कुछ और देखिए, आप क्रिकेट देख लीजिए टीवी पे.
यहां पे कुछ और देखने की बात, जब आप अगर टीवी पे आप देखते हैं तो टीवी पे इन्होंने जैसा कि दो चीजें लिखी हैं, नेटफ्लिक्स में इन्होंने लिखा है पेरेंटियल गार्जियनशिप. अगर आप उसमें लॉग इन करते हो, एक 5 साल का बच्चा अगर कार्टून देख रहा है तो आप कितने देर वहां पे बैठ के देखो?
तो ये पॉसिबल नहीं. आपका कहना है कि पेरेंट्स संभाल नहीं सकते इसलिए सरकार को संभालनी चाहिए?
नहीं, पेरेंट्स संभाल सकते इसलिए सरकार को नहीं संभालनी चाहिए. जब कोई भी विदेशी चीजें यहाँ पे दिखाई जा रही हैं, एटलीस्ट उस पर जो है सरकार का जो है कोई ना कोई हस्तक्षेप जरूर.
क्या आपको लगता है कि ये पूरी नेटफ्लिक्स के सारे कंटेंट को देख के सेंसर करने में कितने लोगों को कितना टाइम बर्बाद करनी पड़ेगी सरकार में? आप मुझे बताइए, टीम कितनी बड़ी चाहिए होगी?
सीबीएफसी बनाई गई, सीबीएफसी के अंडर लाया जाए इनको.
अच्छा, तो एक आपकी पिटीशन मेरे हाथ में है, मैं कुछ पैरा नंबर 6 पढ़ना चाहती हूँ. An instance can be taken from Charlie and the Chocolate Factory, where the scene depicting the animal cow and holy cow abuse is available for view, and viewers of the age 7 and above are watching. This, इससे आपको क्या problem है? Holy cow से आपको क्या problem है? बताइए मुझे.
अगर आप इंडिया में दिखा रहे हैं holy cow पे, आपको भी पता है कि बवाल हो जाता है किसी भी चीज से. तो अगर
बच्चों का प्रोग्राम है मिस्टर राजपूत, बच्चों का प्रोग्राम है और विलायती बच्चे ऐसे बोलते हैं.
बच्चों का प्रोग्राम 18 प्लस तो नहीं होता मैडम? बच्चों का प्रोग्राम
ये तो चाली एंड द चॉकलेट फैक्ट्री तो बच्चों का ही प्रोग्राम है. तो आपको लगता है कि बच्चों का प्रोग्राम सेंसर करनी चाहिए?
नहीं, इसमें नहीं, इस पे मैंने कंटेंट पे बात ही नहीं की. अगर आप पिटीशन का प्रेयर पढ़ेंगी तो कंटेंट नहीं, इस पे पूरे नेटफ्लिक्स और अदर ओटीटी जितने भी ऑनलाइन
पिटीशन पढ़ रही
हूं उन पे बात किया गया.
इस पे आप पिटीशनर हो कि नहीं हो? क्या आपके वकील पिटीशनर
है? यस, इसमें जस्टिस फॉर राइट फाउंडेशन मेरा ही है, पिटीशनर मैं ही हूं.
आप पिटीशनर हो, आपने साइन किया है इस पिटीशन पे?
जी.
तो पिटीशन के बारे में अगर मुझे सवाल पूछने तो मैं आप ही से पूछूंगी ना, सिग्नेचर तो आपकी लगी हुई है कोर्ट के.
बिल्कुल बिल्कुल पूछिए.
तो डिफेंड कीजिए आप. क्या आपने शो देखा है? नहीं देखा. क्या आपने सीक्रेट गेम्स देखा?
नहीं, बिल्कुल ये सो मैंने नहीं देखा है.
आपने नहीं देखा, फिर भी आपने साइन
सीक्रेट गेम के कुछ पार्ट्स मैंने देखे हुए हैं जो कि यूट्यूब नहीं, मैं बता रहा हूँ सीक्रेट गेम के जितने भी पार्ट, कुछ पार्ट यूट्यूब पे डाले गए हैं.
अच्छा, तो आपने शो नहीं देखा,
कैसे चीजें दिखाई? आप आज भी
आपने बिना देखे जज किया, आपको पसंद नहीं आया?
वो इसमें
गेम ऑफ थ्रोन्स देखा आपने?
नहीं, आपको पसंद नहीं. गेम ऑफ थ्रोन्स नहीं देखा.
स्पार्टिकस देखा आपने?
मैडम आपको भी पता एक आर्टिकल
मैंने तो सारे देखे,
हर चीज के लिए
बस मैंने चाली या तो चॉकलेट फैक्ट्री नहीं देखा. मैंने बाकी के सारे देखे, मुझे अच्छे लगे. आपने बिना देख के डिसाइड किया कि वल्गर है, आपने बिना देख के डिसाइड किया कि बैन करनी चाहिए, आपने बिना देख के डिसाइड किया कि आपको ऑफेंस हो रहा है. ये फिर वो पद्मावती की बात हो गई ना, आपको अगर पसंद नहीं है आप मत देखिए।
पद्मावती वाली बात इसमें कुछ नहीं, मैंने बार बार मैं
उन लोगों ने भी वो करनी सेना वालों ने भी ऐसे ही डिसाइड किया था बिना देख के कि उनको पसंद नहीं है। देखिए बिना आपको कैसे डिसाइड किया कि आपको पसंद नहीं है, बाकी लोगों को पसंद आएगा ना।
आप यहाँ पर देखिए, यहाँ पे गवर्नमेंट ने भी दिया हुआ है, गवर्नमेंट ने भी दिया हुआ है, यहाँ पे इनके पास ऐसी कोई इन्फॉर्मेशन नहीं जो इनपे कोई रेगुलेटरी अथॉरिटी हो या फिर लाइसेंस हो। उनके आरटीआई में जवाब दिया गया है जो मैंने मांगा हुआ था, और वहां पर इन कोर्ट में भी गवर्नमेंट के लॉयर के पास ऐसा कोई जवाब नहीं था इस चीज पर।
अच्छा, तो मैंने जो मांगा हुआ सत्यम सिंह राजपूत आपने एक भी शो देखे बिना आपने पिटीशन फाइल किया हुआ है, आप गवर्नमेंट और गवर्नमेंट लॉयर को अभी कोर्ट में बुलाया आपने, आप बैन करने की बात कर रहे हैं, आप देख तो लीजिए ना एक बार शो। आई जस्ट वांट टू रिमाइंड हिम दैट इवन द सेंसर बोर्ड, इफ यू लुक एट द लॉज ऑफ द सेंसर बोर्ड, इट सेज वेरी क्लियरली दैट दे आर नॉट टू कट द फिल्म बट टू रेट इट, एंड इफ दे फाइंड दैट अ फिल्म इज ओनली मेंट फॉर एडल्ट ऑडियंस, यू मेक एन ए रेटिंग एंड मेक श्योर दैट ओनली एडल्ट सी इट। Censoring content, and he keeps talking about why do you keep coming back to the content, because this is about content. Censoring content at the end of the day is old school. We're not old school anymore. Here is the very simple math that has been placed before us by the RBI. If you remember during demonetization, 15.41 lakh crore rupees was demonetized. Currency was demonetized out of our system. 2 years and 10 months later, the RBI has finished counting the money that came back in. 15.28 lakh crore rupees has come back in. That's a shortfall of 10,720 crore rupees. I also want to remind our viewers that apparently district central corporate banks are yet to fully submit all of the money that they had collected at the time. And also some money is expected from Nepal citizens and financial institutions. So that amount might go down even further. Now this is at 99.3%. So 99.3% of the currency that was demonetized out of our system has come back. What does this mean? Was demonetization a success at all? Joining me on the show right now, Mr. P. Chidambaram, former finance minister. Mr. Chidambaram, good evening and thank you for joining us live here on Mirror Now. You've tweeted about this morning as well. Do you believe demonetization was a complete failure?
It's a complete disaster and an absolute failure. Not one of the objectives that was spelled out on November 8, 2016 was achieved. In fact, I had predicted on the next day that none of the objectives will be achieved.
Mr. Chidambaram, a couple of days ago, there was a story that came out into the press that there was apparently a committee headed by Veerappa Moily with a draft report on demonetization. This was the Parliamentary Standing Committee. Have you had the opportunity to read through that report? Do you know what is in it? And is it true it has been stalled by members of Parliament?
I'm not a member of the committee, mm-hmm. and therefore I have no access to the draft report of the committee. All that I know is what the newspapers report. I sincerely hope that the parliamentary committee members act in a non-partisan manner. Privately, even BJP members tell us that demonetization was a failure and they are unable to answer their constituents why the government did demonetization. I have not come across a single economist who has a good word to say about demonetization.
There's source-based information that tells us that the report pegs the loss to GDP at 1%. Do you believe 1% is a fair estimate of the kind of loss the country has incurred because of demonetization?
No, the numbers show that the loss is 1.5%. What was the GDP growth in 2015-16? Before demonetization, and what was the GDP growth in 2017-18? In those 2 years, over a period of 2 years, GDP declined by 1.5%, and that is 2.25 lakh crore. In fact, you will recall that I had estimated that the loss will be 1.5%, and Dr. Manmohan Singh had estimated it may be as high as 2%. Mm.
But the argument that comes from the government right now is that in combination with GST and all of the other measures that the government has been taking, the accountability in the system has gone up, the number of taxpayers have gone up, the number of companies or shell companies have been weeded out of the system. And so in the long term, India is actually better for it. Do you agree?
Have other countries not achieved digitization? Have other countries not identified shell companies? Have other countries not increased the number of filers? Did we not increase the number of filers between, say, 1997, when income tax rates were sharply reduced, and 2015? So all this could have been achieved through other means. Tell me one country in the world which achieved objectives like digitization, increasing compliance with income tax by demonetization. This is trying to justify an absolutely foolish act. The same results could have been achieved by other measures. We had introduced many such measures, and a number of filers did increase. Third-party reporting, mandatory payment by check over a certain amount. All those are measures which increase the number of filers.
The RBI has also noted in its report that they have printed 23.8 billion notes at the cost of 8,000 crore rupees. Now, this is also demonetization has also brought down the revenue of the RBI, and they've noted that the credit uptake of PSUs has not returned. Do you believe all of this is a reaction to demonetization?
Of course. Go back and read one of the columns I wrote then. I had estimated the cost of printing. I'd estimated the cost to customers who lost incomes, who had to borrow money. I estimated the loss to the RBI in terms of RBI's income. I mean, demonetization has exacted a huge cost on India's economy and India's institutions and the Indian people. Over 100 lives were lost. 15 crore daily wage earners, on whom depend 45 crore people in this country, did not have wages or income for nearly 8 weeks. They had to borrow money to survive. Now, all that cost is inestimable. And the government doesn't care. It spent 8,000 crore on printing new notes. It would have spent a very large amount on destroying the old notes. RBI lost revenue. Even that calculation will reach a staggering figure. But what about the cost to the public? What about the cost to the average bank customer who lost his money, who lost his income?
I'm being told that the actual number of the cost of printing of notes was closer to 12,877 because it was 8,000 crore rupees in the first tranche and a little over 4,000 crore rupees in the second tranche. But if we actually focus on the three purposes that were listed out by the Prime Minister when he announced demonetization back in 2016, it was first of all to remove black money, to bring down terror financing, and to bring down counterfeit currency. Have we achieved partially even any of these three?
Yes. Has any one of them been achieved?
Yes.
Has anyone been achieved? All right, we'll start with one by one. Has black money been wiped out? What is the source of funding of elections today? What is the source of funding of political rallies? What is the source of funding of yatras? What about the cash seizures made by the Income Tax Department in the last year and a half? In Tamil Nadu, in Mumbai, in Delhi, in Punjab, huge amounts of cash have been seized. Now, is that black money or white money? So black money has not been wiped out. Hordes of black money have been seized. The second one about terrorist financing. In fact, look at the numbers on J&K alone. The number of incidents have gone up. The number of infiltrations have gone up. The number of militants killed has gone up, the number of security personnel who lost their lives has gone up, and the number of civilian casualties has gone up. So violence has increased, which means terrorism is more intense today. And if there is financing of terrorism, how is it done? It was done then by black money. It is being done now by black money. I'm sure nobody in government is saying that the terrorists are being financed by digital transaction money. And the third one is counterfeit currency. A few days after demonetization, counterfeit currency was detected, and counterfeit currency is being detected. Only, I think, a month and a half ago, counterfeit currency was detected in Coimbatore. 2,000 rupee notes, 500 rupee notes, counterfeit notes. And in fact, one of the officers said, counterfeiting has become so sophisticated that we can barely distinguish between a genuine note and a counterfeit note. Just go back and look at the archives of newspapers. You will find that report. Therefore, none of the objectives was achieved, because none of the objectives was achievable through demonetization.
Let's assume I was selling you these coffee mugs that I was importing from overseas. I was importing them at 40 rupees and selling it to you at 50 rupees. Now, the price of the coffee mug globally fell down to 5 rupees. But I continued to sell them to you at 50 rupees and kept the margin, saying that this is good. This gives us some buffer in case the price ever goes up. I made a killing of a margin of 45 rupees, and then slowly over time, the price came back up again. So now the global price is back to 50 rupees, and now you are paying 100 rupees because I have not reduced the margin I was making to begin with. It simply boils down to this, and this is something we must know. The government has no control over the rise and fall of the rupee globally. The rupee is not in any way linked to our self-respect, our patriotism, or the strength of our country. It is not. It is simply a currency that gets traded. Having said that, the government can and has in the past intervened to arrest the fall of the rupee. When the rupee does fall, it impacts us because it makes those things that we import more expensive, like cell phones, for example. All our cell phones are being imported from either China or other countries. When you go overseas to study, when you buy laptops, when you buy computers, everything that you buy that's imported becomes more expensive, but that's not something that we should worry about. It makes petrol, diesel, and LPG, which is your cooking gas, more expensive. And when that becomes more expensive, everything becomes more expensive, as we've shown you over the last couple of weeks. What the government can do is, you remember that margin you were making when the price came down? Reduce your margin. Reduce the margin you are making on petrol and diesel. It will give relief to the citizens of India. So the government cannot control the value of the rupee, but you can cushion the impact that it has on the citizens. And cushion you must.
Two things. One, if you take the jobs, about 80% of the jobs are in the informal sector. They are not in the formal sector. That means people have to work. It could be the pakoda wallas, which Mr. Modi talked about. It could be the chai wala somewhere down the road. But they are the people who are actually making the jobs. The 20-25% is the formal sector.
No, hang on. Hang on. Krish Lakshmikant, I refuse to. I'm going to stop you there. I refuse to count pakoda walas and chai walas as job creation. That is not job creation. First of all, pakoda walas and chai walas occupy portions of the footpath that has not officially been given to them. They could be uprooted and tossed out anytime the local government decides to clean up that area. That is not secure. Secondly, there is child labor involved in these stalls. There are people being, you know, employed there who are not given benefits, who are worked beyond labor laws, who are not paid daily wage. We cannot, hand on our heart, count this as a government, as actual job creation. That's completely unfair. Do we want pakora shops and chai shops to mushroom Absolutely. On every footpath? Can we afford that? Do we want pedestrians to walk on the roads? Do we want cars to run over pedestrians? That is not an organized way to do anything. And that's a completely wrong assessment of the question of jobs. And you, of all people, should not propagate that pakora wala idea. You know as well as I do that it's completely unfair.
I just gave an example.
Exactly.
You take the drivers who are working in Ola. Ola has 300,000 drivers working with them. Uber has something like 200,000. You mean to say they are the formal sector? None of them have ESI, none
yes,
of them have
Yes, but they are not making pakodas.
But they are
there,
all
is, there is there is a ledger
day-to-day.
Somewhere with their names against it and how much money they are making and their bank accounts to which this money is being transferred
yes,
and
sir.
The fact that they are all above the age of 18 and they have licenses and they are working for a licensed company. A pakoda shop is not the same thing.
No, Faye, the Ola driver is not working for Ola. He's a contractor. If today it's become a contract economy and these people are not counted by the government.
So you are Krish Lakshmi Kant on
counted.
My show today
the
as the managing
sector.
Director. Hang on. As the managing director of Headhunters India, Krish Lakshmi Kant, you are on my show today arguing that working in a pakoda shop is a job that should be counted as on behalf of the government of India as job creation. 47 rupees tax on a product that is worth less than the tax that you're paying. 123% tax. None of it justifies the tax that the government is making off us.
46,000 crore worth of defense procurement has been sanctioned in a day. From where this money will come? Money is coming from the taxes given by we citizen.
You were supposed to make roads and create infrastructure without picking my pocket and robbing from me. What about all of the other sources of income for the government?
When the prices were coming down for 4 years in a row, why didn't you give us the benefit of a lower price?
Why is our defense still understaffed? Why don't we have the equipment that the defense needs? Why are people not safe in any of our states? Why is rape still taking place the way it's taking place? Give us hisab and then take money from our pockets and then we won't come. I have a colleague, Vishal Monga, who tracks this case for us. He's currently made this phone call to the helpline.
Madam, ye women helpline hai ji?
Haan ji.
Ye kis area ke liye hai, madam?
आप कहाँ से बोल रहे हो?
मैं जी चंडीगढ़ से बोल रहा हूँ मैडम.
सर आप नोट करो चंडीगढ़ का नंबर.
ये आपकी किस एरिया के लिए है?
सर एक्चुअली ये मोहाली के लिए है.
मोहाली के लिए है?
हाँ जी.
और ये कोई क्या नाम है अपना पंचकुला में कोई नहीं है?
पंचकुला सर तुसी कंट्रोल रूम तो पता कर लो.
अच्छा.
नंबर ले लो.
ठीक है थैंक यू.
चंडीगढ़ का नंबर लेना.
चंडीगढ़ का नंबर दे दो. ये मोहाली है जी.
हाँ जी.
ठीक है मैडम मेहरबानी.
नोट करो सर. नोट
बोलो जी.
0172 0172 7474
9194. ठीक है थैंक यू थैंक यू थैंक यू.
Now, Vishal Monga is a very polite senior journalist who had the time to write down a number. He was not a woman who was in distress, who was being chased or being stalked or being raped. Mr. Raman Malik, do you want to brag about the number anymore? There was a number which you gave us, which we called. Somebody answered and said, this number is only applicable for Mohali. If you are in Chandigarh, if you are in Panchkula, I'll give you another number. Aap control room dekh lijiye. Aap control room mein jaake kar lijiye. Is this how a helpline functions, Mr. Raman Malik? What if it was a woman in distress who was calling? Would she have the time to write down a number?
Are
we joking
these
here?
These short numbers are circle oriented. I do not know the intricacy of it.
No, I have just read the news reports
calling,
of the press releases. I'm sorry, Mr. Raman Malik, I'm done with this now. I have read the news reports. The press release says this number is a helpline number for all the women of Haryana. All the women of Haryana who live in Mohali.
I know, that's what I'm saying.
Why are you
please
making promises when you don't know what you're saying? You said this number works. You said this number works. You said this number works.
If you do not yell, I'll be able to listen
no,
what you're saying.
No, I'm sorry,
stop,
Mr. Raman Malik. You cannot ask me to be civil anymore. I refuse to be civil.
Saying.
I take offense. I take offense on behalf of every woman
there's
on this
no
country.
No,
I don't care. I don't
no
care
issue.
What you think anymore.
Do not jump
I listen
around.
To you. I wrote down what you said.
Answer.
I tested it.
Answer.
It turned out to be false, which means, Mr. Raman Malik, you do not take this seriously. You do not take this seriously. The answers you are giving us today are not serious. You have not come prepared with data. You have not come prepared with answers. You are not prepared, which means you do not take it seriously. If we were having a conversation about what's happening in Parliament and what Rahul Gandhi did, you would have come prepared. But you don't take this seriously, and that is the problem with our country. I refuse to be civil. I refuse to be polite. I could be next, Mr. Raman Malik. Every woman watching could be next. Because you people don't take it seriously. How dare you? How dare you put us in this position? How dare you announce a number that you don't take seriously? No, Mr. Raman Malik. I don't care what you're ready to do anymore. I don't care what you're ready to do anymore. I don't care what Mr. Manohar Lal Khattar is ready to do anymore. Because it's been promise after promise after promise. Do you not understand what this means?
We are not over here. I'm not over here to caress your theatrics. Sorry.
All right, Mr. Raman Malik, you are free to get up and leave. Because you obviously don't take this seriously enough. And you do not understand. You do not understand what this means. You do not understand the gravity of the situation. You do not understand what it means to a woman, the fear of being raped. You sit here smugly on national television and you gave me a number that doesn't work. I challenge you. You have your phone in your hand right now. I challenge you to dial that number and see what happens. Dial that number and see what happens. Put it on speakerphone. Dial that number and see what happens. Ask the person. Do you remember the number, Mr. Raman Malik? Do you remember the number? What is the number?
Namaskar, the Mahila Helpline Gurgaon.
Haan ji, kahan se bol rahe hain? Mahila Helpline Gurgaon.
Ekpetyan Woman Police Station.
Haan ji. एक चीज बताइए, अगर कोई महिला के अगेंस्ट क्राइम होता है तो आप कितनी देर में रिस्पॉन्ड करते हैं और कैसे उसको ट्रैक करेंगे?
संबंधित पुलिस स्टेशन में फॉरवर्ड करते हैं हम।
और आपका रिस्पॉन्स टाइम कितना रहेगा?
आधा घंटा।
रिस्पॉन्स टाइम कितना रहता है आपको अगर?
हाफ एन आवर, आधा घंटा।
तो अगर इस दौरान कुछ हो जाता है, आपसे मैं बात कर रहा हूँ, मैं रमन मलिक बोल रहा हूँ, मैं आपसे बात कर रहा हूँ, मेरे को ये बताइए कि आप जो कंप्लेंट्स आती हैं उनको कैसे हैंडल करते हैं? एकदम
हम कंप्लेंट लेके मैडम से और जिस एरिया से बोल रही हैं उस एरिया के नजदीकी पुलिस स्टेशन में फॉरवर्ड करते हैं। वहां से वो या तो पुलिस स्टेशन से पुलिस भेजते हैं या पीसीआर राइडर जो इलाके में होती है पुलिस स्टेशन वाले वहां से उस पीसीआर राइडर को।
और अगर उनका ये मैसेज आता है कि वो इमीडिएटली उनको मदद चाहिए तो आप कैसे करते हैं?
हम वहां पे बता देते हैं कि मैडम को इमीडिएटली चाहिए, जल्द से जल्द आप प्रोवाइड कीजिए पीसीआर राइडर जो भी आपकी एयर में है उनको तुरंत आप भेजिए वहां पे।
ठीक है, धन्यवाद।
Well, Raman Malik, I think we have our answer. I am not going to editorialize after that conversation. It went on air. It was for live television. Everybody heard it. I don't need to interpret it. We all heard that conversation. We all heard the response time.
So don't respond? That is what you want to say?
No, I'm not saying anything.
They did not respond?
I'm not saying a word.
I asked them the entire procedure.
You put the entire conversation on air. I put the entire conversation on air. I told you, I'm not editorializing. I am not saying one word. I am not going to tell the audience what to believe. Neither are you going to tell the audience what to believe. They heard that conversation.
No other government before this.
What are you talking about, Vaibhav Agarwal? When will you stop talking about previous governments? You've been in power for 5 years. Nobody remembers the previous government. You came in with a promise that we will see a different India, a cleaner India, a better India, a safer India. Deliver what you promised. There is a reason why previous governments were shunned out of power and they were booted out of power by the same people who are upset today. They were booted out of power for this exact reason, because women did not feel safe in this country. You promised a change. Where is the change that you promised? Why didn't you make a promise saying that hame 15 saal lagenge acche din lane mein, to hame vote de dijiye aur fir vote de dijiye aur fir vote de dijiye aur fir 15-20 saal baad acche din aayenge? Why didn't you say that? That would have been honest.
Because lately, since the government has come in, there have been too much. There have been a growth in the number of urban naxals that have that have propped up, the intellectuals and the liberals that have propped up and started saying that the country is not safe. But the country is absolutely safe to a larger sense. Yeah. And, you know, it's
why is it not safe? Because the four women on this panel have not been raped. How dare you? How dare you, Vaibhav Agarwal?
It's not.
How dare you?
Let the people decide.
Look at what we're discussing.
Of India is in distress.
Let the people decide that. I can't, as a government, we cannot get inside the heads of the people and say, hey, don't rape. Yes, I agree to everyone on the panel saying that there can be laws that can be made as stringent as possible.
That is the dirty depth that she's fallen to, you know, Mr. Agarwal.
So let's not just get the first opportunity and blame the government.
आप मुझे बताइए, आप मुझे बताइए कि एक यूपी के एक पुलिस अफसर को मारा गया, आपके बजरंग दल के सदस्य वहां क्या कर रहे थे?
हम बता रहे हैं ना आपको, बजरंग दल जो गांव योगेश राज है उसका गांव भी वहीं समीप उसी घटना के स्थल के आसपास है. लोगों ने वहां वह प्रशासन ने बुलाया, पुलिस एसएसपी बुलंदशहर फोन करके कहते हैं कि भाई घटना में हमारा सहयोग कीजिए. ये विषय तो एसएसपी बुलंदशहर ने किया कहा ना, और उसके उपरांत जो जो गाय वहां कटी गई हैं वह इत्तेजमा में आने वाले लोगों के लिए शिविर लगाए गए थे भोजन के, उसके लिए काटी गई थी. इस बात पर पर्दा डालने के लिए हमारे कार्यकर्ता पर एफआईआर कर दी जाती है. और मैं इसमें मांग करता हूं कि इसकी जांच होनी चाहिए और उच्च स्तरीय कमेटी बनकर जांच होनी चाहिए. हमारे कार्यकर्ता पर जो आरोप लगाया गया है वो निराधार है. दूसरा विषय यह है, पुलिस को 30 तारीख से घटना की जानकारी दी जा रही थी बार बार कि गोकशी हो रही है. उससे पहले भी
मिस्टर बलराज डूंगर, मुझसे आप मुझे मुझे आपसे ये पूछना है कि कल एक दो इंसान की मौत हो गई, उसमें एक पुलिस अफसर था. मैं आपको आपसे पुलिस अफसर के बारे में पूछ रही हूँ और आप गाय के बारे में बात कर रहे हैं. क्या आपके आपके हिसाब से पुलिस अफसर इम्पोर्टेंट है यहाँ पे, ज्यादा मायने रखते हैं या गाय?
उसके उस पर चर्चा नहीं होनी चाहिए?
नहीं,
उसके लिए हुई है, वो चर्चा नहीं होनी.
मुझे कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ता, मैं पुलिस अफसर के बारे में बात कर रही हूँ, मैं गाय के बारे में बात नहीं कर रही हूँ.
ठीक है, ठीक है.
मुझे नहीं सुनना है गाय के बारे में, मुझे इंसानों के बारे में सुनना है.
क्यों, गाय इंसान नहीं है?
नहीं, गाय इंसान नहीं, गाय जानवर होती है बलराज साहब.
जानवर नहीं है गाय, 100 करोड़ हिंदुओं की आत्माओं का प्रतीक है, हिंदुओं की आत्माओं का प्रतीक है मैडम. और वह गाय भगवान कृष्ण ने भी नंगे पैर गौ माता की सेवा की थी.
तो आप मुझे ये बताइए कि आप भगवान आपसे ये कहते हैं कि पुलिस अफसर को जाके मारो, गोली मारो?
मैंने तो
ये कौन से रिलीजन में ये सिखाया जाता है बताइए मुझे, कौन से रिलीजन में सिखाया जाता है कि पुलिस अफसर को जाके गोली मारो गाय के नाम पे?
मैडम, हमारे कार्यकर्ता ने गोली नहीं मारी. आप कैसे कह सकती हैं कि हमारे कार्यकर्ता ने गोली?
एफआईआर में लिखा है, आपने एफआईआर पढ़ी?
आरोप मेरे पास एफआईआर की कॉपी है,
पढ़ लीजिए फिर.
मैंने पढ़ लिया मैडम, मैं आपको बताना चाहता हूँ, मैंने एफआईआर को पढ़ लिया है. आरोप लगाना और सिद्ध होना दोनों अलग अलग विषय है.
हाँ हाँ, सिद्ध होने से पहले आप लोग इंतजाम मैनेज कर लेंगे ना बात को?
क्या मैनेज कर लेंगे?
आप मुझे बताइए, ये योगेश राज और उसके बाकी साथी वहाँ कर क्या रहे थे?
मैंने बताया,
उन्होंने रास्ता बंद करके पुलिस के साथ हाथापाय क्यों किया था बताइए मुझे, क्यों किया?
बंद नहीं किया रास्ता, उन्होंने रास्ता स्थानीय ग्रामीणों ने इकट्ठा होकर गौ हत्या का विरोध किया था, पुलिस को सूचना दी, पुलिस संतुष्ट कार्रवाई नहीं कर पाई उसके उपरांत.
अच्छा, तो आप मुझे एक बात बताइए कि पुलिस को जब उन्होंने इन्फॉर्मेशन दिया था और जब उन्होंने डिसाइड किया था कि संतुष्ट कार्रवाई नहीं हो रही है, आप कह रहे हो कि संतुष्ट कार्रवाई नहीं कर पाई, कितना टाइम था? आधे घंटे का टाइम?
नहीं सुनो,
15 मिनट.
दूसरी चीज उधर, हमने आपको टाइम टू टाइम बताया ना, योगेश राज 1:03 पर एफआईआर ले रहा था थाने में. 5 किलोमीटर की दूरी है थाने से, 5 किलोमीटर की दूरी तय करना, 100-150 लोगों को बुलाना, क्या इसमें समय नहीं लगेगा मैडम? 5 किलोमीटर की दूरी तय करनी है और दूरी
तो आपने डिसाइड कर लिया बलराज जी कि यूपी पुलिस ठीक तरह से आपकी तहकीकात नहीं कर रही थी.
हम पुलिस
तो
के
आपने कैसे डिसाइड किया?
हम पुलिस के सहयोगी हैं, पुलिस के विरोधी नहीं है.
आप तो पुलिस के विरोधी बात कर रहे हो अभी.
नहीं, हमने विरोध की बात कहाँ कही है?
आपने कहा कि एफआईआर में जो लिखा है गलत लिखा है, आपने कहा जब आपके लोग जब बजरंग दल के कार्यकर्ता गए थे पुलिस के पास गौ हत्या के बारे में बात करनी, तो पुलिस ने ठीक से काम नहीं किया, तो आप कौन होते हो ये डिसाइड करना कि पुलिस ने ठीक से काम नहीं किया?
मैंने केवल ये कहा आरोप गलत लगा।
नवंबर में, मैं नवंबर की बात कर रही हूँ, अभी उत्तर प्रदेश की बात कर रही हूँ
जी,
16 साल की लड़की को रेप किया गया था मुजफ्फरनगर में
जी।
23 साल की औरत को रेप किया था मुजफ्फरनगर में। एनआरआई को रेप किया था मथुरा में। 4 साल की बच्ची को रेप करके मर्डर किया था ईथा में। 5 साल की बच्ची को रेप किया था मुजफ्फरनगर में। उसके अलावा पिछले 2 दिन में एक रेप विक्टिम को गोली मारा गया, दूसरी औरत को जलाया गया ताकि वो पुलिस स्टेशन जाके कंप्लेंट ना करे। ये सुन के आपको बुरा नहीं लगता? आप लोगों को गाय के बारे में बहुत बुरा लगता है, लेकिन औरतों के बारे में आपको बुरा ही नहीं लगता? आप उसके बारे में प्रोटेस्ट क्यों नहीं करते?
हाँ, मैं बता रहा हूँ आपको, बिल्कुल बुरा लगता है।
बुरा लगता है ना?
बहुत बहुत बुरा लगता
है। औरतें भी इंसान होते हैं,
बिल्कुल 100%। अभी
औरतें बेटर स्टिल, औरतें माँ होते हैं हमारे सारे, जितने सारे आपके बजरंग दल में आदमी आए उनके सारे माँ औरतें ही थे।
बिल्कुल बिल्कुल,
गाय तो बाद में आई, पहले औरत आई थी।
मैं उत्तर दूं
तो उसके बारे में आप लोग प्रोटेस्ट क्यों नहीं करते?
मैं उसका उत्तर दूं क्या?
हाँ बोलिए ना।
मैं बिल्कुल, ये जो घटनाएं हैं इन घटनाओं से बजरंग दल कभी इनकी घटनाओं का समर्थन नहीं करता, चाहे वो बलात्कार की घटना हो, चाहे हत्या की घटना हो, चाहे गो हत्या की घटना हो, कभी इसका समर्थन नहीं करता। मुजफ्फरनगर में रश्मि नाम की लड़की को पिछली वर्ष और जहर देकर मारने का प्रयास किया गया एक मुस्लिम युवक के द्वारा, धर्मांतरण करने का प्रयास किया गया था। उसको उसकी पूरी लड़ाई, उसको मेडिकल में हमारे कार्यकर्ता,
ये हिंदू मुस्लिम की लड़ाई हमारे चैनल पे नहीं चलेगा, आप प्लीज दूसरे चैनल पे चल जाइए। कट दैट लाइन प्लीज फॉर मी।
मैं डिफेंड नहीं करना चाहता हूँ, जो भी हुआ किसी का ना किसी का तो फॉल्ट है ये, लेकिन मैं एक ही बात कहना चाहता हूँ। जब पोस्ता में ब्रिज गिरा था उस टाइम में भी आप लोगों ने देखा है ममता बनर्जी ने पूरा रात वहां पर बैठे बैठे रेस्क्यू का काम किया था।
नहीं नहीं, लेट मी जस्ट स्टॉप यू देयर मिस्टर रॉय, चीफ मिनिस्टर का काम रात भर बैठ के रेस्क्यू करना नहीं है। उसके लिए एनडीआरएफ होता है, उसके लिए फायर सर्विस ऑफिसर्स होते हैं, वो चीफ मिनिस्टर का काम नहीं है। चीफ मिनिस्टर का काम ब्रिज को फिक्स करने की,
कोई भी एक्सीडेंट का रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी
दिस इज नॉट एन एक्सीडेंट
आप लोग डाल देते हैं। आप लोग एक बार भी नहीं बोल रहे हैं बेनारस में जो भी कोलैप्स हुआ उसका मोदी का मोदी दाई है और जोगी जी जाई है।
डिस्पिकेबल पॉलिटिक्स
मैडम, बंगाल अभी टारगेट है आप लोगों का, नेशनल चैनल का ड्यूटी है
बनारस में कोलैप्स हुआ,
इसलिए कोई भी इंसिडेंट को आप लोग बंगाल में कोलैप्स किया
जाए जाए
दाई है
बनारस में कोलैप्स हुआ।
वन सेकंड मिस्टर घोष,
आप लोग एक बार भी नहीं बोल रहे हैं 40 साल का वो ब्रिज के लिए 3 करोड़ रुपया ऑलरेडी सेंक्शन हुआ था। बाजू में रेल का काम चल रहा था, वहां पर वाइब्रेट मशीन का जो प्रॉब्लम था, ये सब छोटा छोटा जो भी प्रॉब्लम है इसके लिए इतना बड़ा घटना घटा, और इसके लिए जो भी पनिशमेंट मिलना था ये पनिशमेंट
ऐसा नहीं बोलता,
कोई ना कोई पीडब्ल्यूडी हो,
शिखा मुखर्जी
मिलेगा।
शिखा मुखर्जी, वन सेकंड, मिस्टर रॉय
बनर्जी को काली लगाने के लिए आपको क्वेश्चन तो वही होगा ना, आप तो एज ए जनरल पब्लिक, एज ए जनरल पर्सन बात करते हैं, आपको क्वेश्चन का आंसर मैं देने के लिए तैयार हूँ, लेकिन पार्टी रिप्रेजेंटेटिव बात जब चालू करेंगे
जेंटलमैन प्लीज स्टॉप यलिंग, नन ऑफ अस आर इंप्रेस्ड।
आपको
काम डाउन मिस्टर रॉय, काम डाउन
आप तो मिस्टर रॉय देख रहे ममता बनर्जी का बंगाल आने का बाद डिप्लोमा में कैसा हुआ, आप लोग ये बात तो पहले ही बोल रहे हैं ममता बनर्जी आ गए आया पंचायत के इलेक्शन,
प्लीज आपको बात सुनने
के लिए तैयार ही नहीं।
ऑलराइट, आई फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वांट टू अपोलोजाइज टू माय ऑडियंस फॉर दैट डिस्प्ले ऑफ डिस्पिकेबल पॉलिटिक्स दैट वी जस्ट सॉ। At the end of the day, a bridge has collapsed. But it boils down to this. Whether you're watching right now in Mumbai, Thane, Pune, Bangalore, Hyderabad, Chennai, Delhi, Gurgaon, Noida, and now Kolkata, what do we all have in common? We have in common the fact that the corruption in our local and state governments is more important to our politicians than our lives. We lose citizens on a regular basis. Look at the ridiculous avoidable reasons why people die in urban areas. Garbage falls on their heads in Delhi.
They fall into manholes in Mumbai. Floods in Chennai. All of these things are amply avoidable. This visual you remember of a pomegranate farmer in Maharashtra flinging the pomegranates on the floor out of frustration because he was only getting a price of 10 rupees a kilo. This other visual came out of Nasik, where a farmer dumped onions on the road because he didn't have the money to take them back to his farm. And even if he did take them back to his farm, where would he store them? It was simpler to dump it on the road. Now, of all of the 13 protests we've covered on this channel, they've all involved a demand for better farm pricing. And so we decided to understand what's really going on. Now, my colleague Disha Shah followed farmers and their produce from the farm to the market to your Sabzi Mandi to trace the number of times the vegetables change hands and the various people who make a cut along the way. The process really takes all night. Farmers in India put approximately, for example, 10 rupees to grow 1 kg of tomatoes. Their costs include labor, seeds, fertilizer, water, electricity and diesel. Rent on their equipment as well in some cases. And when they take their produce to the market, they come across a slew of people ranging from transporter agents, traders, wholesalers, retailers, small retailers, before their produce reaches the customer. During this time, the price of a kg of tomato rises and you and I buy it for between 20 or 25 rupees. But the farmer is not making any more than 2 or 3 rupees. Remember, the cost of the driver, the truck, the loaders, the fuel, the entry fees and the parking fees of the APMC market are deducted before the farmer is finally paid. So putting it simply, this is where we are. The cost of producing 1 kilo of tomatoes is 10 rupees. The farmer makes, after spending 10 rupees, he makes 2 rupees a kilo. A loss of 80%. No business makes sense on those numbers. Neither you nor I would enter or invest in any business that functioned on that mathematics. Now the cycle is no different for other vegetables like onions, potatoes or brinjals. And what's troubling is that the farmers aren't even getting a proper auction for their produce in the APMC market, which should be the norm. Instead, wholesalers tend to have pre-arranged deals with traders. And the brunt of that is felt by the farmer who is not given a choice. No wonder then, farming is no longer viable.
I will say that this government has first time has seen the entire problem in a very, very, very unified and integrated way. How? Let me see how.
How?
We have launched a couple of programs and a couple of facilities like that Inam portals, then E-Rakam portals, then Agri Udan 2017, and then we have this negotiable warehousing receipt.
Okay, E-Rakam portal.
At the
okay.
end, we have the Gram Sambad mobile apps. And what is the objective of all these things? The okay. biggest problem for this country was the producer is not getting the right price and the consumer is paying the more price. So in between the slabs, you know, there is a lot of intervention and which had the value added effects.
No, Mr. Bhaskar Ghosh, one second. Forgive me. I have to stop you for a second because just to go over the points that you have noted, Inam portal, E-Rakam portal, yeah. warehousing receipts and mobile apps. Disha, did you come across any of this when you met with the farmers or the wholesalers?
Not at all.
Mandar?
Yeah, Bharat Net projects.
May I talk about Inam?
Just one second, Mandar.
No. The thing is, these are all things which are floated.
Your question was what government has done. Okay, but you gave me the name of four projects.
That's something. Let us restrict to academic questions. What we are today discussing, that what are the governments has taken the steps
No, okay, so you want to ask academic questions, Mr. Ghosh. I'll ask you academic questions. Mr. Bhaskar Ghosh, the government of India has withheld from the general public the total number of farmer suicides that took place last year, which should have been released with the NCRB data, but was not. It was instead handed over to the Agriculture Ministry and never released to the general public. Now, we do not know how many farmers in India committed suicide after the decision of demonetization and GST were taken. Why is the government withholding that information? Academically, please answer the question.
Yes. The question is that, first of all, you are correlating these two issues, that the farmer's debt with demonetization, which absolutely, according to me, is not right. I cannot say wrong, but it's not a right. Number two, if we have published this particular figure, right, every death in this country, be it farmer, be it non-farmer, especially farmers, is painful. So number of farmers' death may be, it's very important for a debate. But question is that government is sympathetic, government is very reactive, and government is absolutely, absolutely sensitive towards this farmers' issue, and which governments is time to time is trying to rectify if there is any fault, but try to improve.
How are you doing that by not releasing the numbers into the public space? Also, the NCRB, which is the National Crimes Records Bureau, has been releasing this number on an annual basis for several years. It's only in the last 1 year that the number has not been released. How is this the answer to my question? Why has the number not been released?
That is the job of the agriculture departments, and it is their job to release it. And specifically, I cannot say that why, because it should not happen. If it's happened like this, it should not happen that we don't releasing the numbers. But I'm not going by the numbers. I'm talking about the death of any farmer is absolutely unfortunate for this country, for the government, and for the party.
Why has this man not been arrested? Why is this disgraceful display of some sort of respect for the power that he holds? This man should have been arrested today. He was allowed to walk away. There is no one on this panel who agrees with the Kerala police. They have failed. Why have they failed?
Of the Kerala High Court, and individual views should not be placed in this manner when the matter is sub judice. My point is, let us firmly stand by this lady. Give her the courage that witnesses don't
lip
run
service.
Away. And when people abuse her, ministers
lip
and the
service.
Speaker of Kerala Assembly have come out in defense of her. So let us not worry.
Lip service.
We have to fight. And like Hadia, she will get her rights.
Lip service, Mr. Sunit Chopra. Let it be noted this evening that Mr. Sunit Chopra of the CPM did nothing
not
but filibuster and play politics when it came to rape. The Kerala government has failed in the most disgraceful fashion in this particular case to do its job, Sunit Chopra. And I'm sorry, no amount of talking that you're going to do today is going to address that.
We don't want vigilantism by the courts.
Mr. Chopra, Hang on. Let me just speak with Mr. Chopra, please, because this is becoming entertaining now at this point. Mr. Chopra, you cannot say you don't want the police and the courts to be vigilantism, because vigilantism, by definition, is taking the law into your own hands. The court is the law. That cannot possibly work. You seem to have misunderstood the word vigilantism. The question is, why haven't you arrested this man? And you haven't been able to offer us an answer.
Because the court, in its wisdom, it's a bench, it's not an individual. The court, in its wisdom, will decide what to do. The court will not bow to you.
Let the record show that the Kerala government has failed to deliver justice, that the Kerala police has failed to do its job. It is absolutely shocking and disgraceful what is happening in this case. Not only did the entire Catholic Church, from here to the very top, in the Vatican in Rome, fail this one particular nun, but the thing that is stronger than any Bible in this country is the Constitution and the IPC, and that has failed as well in this case because the police did not do its job. The Kerala government at this point seems more influenced by this bishop than anything else. I don't know if the Kerala government is playing vote bank politics, but I'm sure that nobody in Kerala, as citizens who are going to vote, are impressed with this sort of behavior. I do not want to hear about your arguments, BJP and Congress, because you went to Supreme Court and fought this together. And at that point, you surprisingly arrived at an understanding of some sort. Is it any wonder, viewers? I want to ask you this. You all use mobile phones. Which country did your mobile phone come from? Is it an Indian company? Where was it made? Is it an Indian company? Look around you to the number of foreign companies that are currently benefiting. The big startups in our country. Who owns them? Indian companies or foreign companies? Chinese companies. Big startups. All the big startups we want to be proud of today. Who owns them? Indians or Chinese? Do a Google search, you'll find it. Today, our parliament decided how they're going to use our money. How they're going to spend our money. They didn't talk about it, they just passed it. Shocking, shocking, shocking. They stepped away from what should have been done. They let us all down, each and every one of us. If you live in this country, you've paid taxes, and today your money was treated irresponsibly. Your citizenship was treated irresponsibly. Your vote was treated irresponsibly. They legalized corruption in politics from 1976 onwards. Not a single question was asked. Why would you need to backdate an amendment to a law to 1976 unless you did something in the last 42 years that you no longer want to be brought up in court? This is what they don't want you to know. And by they, I mean every one of them. Because the opposition had the option of not creating a ruckus today, of putting the citizen first and actually asking questions. It chose not to. The government had the option of acknowledging what the opposition wanted, answering their questions and then passing the bill, which the government chose not to. There is no difference. The only person who lost today, viewer, is you and I. Our money, our taxes, our country, our democracy, our vote, our parliament. We lost today. No other conversation is more important than this one. Thanks for watching.